Oh crap, here comes Pac-Man again. That's right, we got some more Pac-Man commercials to look at, so let's just jump right into it.
Think ColecoVision plays all Atari cartridges.
You mean it can't?
Here's Pac-Man on ColecoVision. But here's Pac-Man on the Atari 5200 Super System.
Now you're talking.
And it doesn't work on ColecoVision.
But won't Jungle Hunt?
Not with real arcade graphics.
Ms. Pac-Man?
This Ms. plays only on the Atari 5200 Super System. And now there's an adapter.
For 2600 games?
Nearly 300 2600 games.
Super!
System, now with a $30 rebate and Pac-Man from Atari.
Did that ever come out? Did the 2600 converter for the 5200 ever come out? Because if that did, that's a really cool thing for back then. Granted, that would also require you to play a 5200 with that horrible controller that probably won't even be working in the first place.
So, you got friends. But imagine if you had one special friend.
Hi, I'm your buddy.
One that would do anything for you.
Here, drink this.
Chewy.
Where are this?
Well, you can with Pac-Man 2, the cool interactive cartoon. He's your best pal, and no matter how much you abuse him, he'll still come back for more. So get Pac-Man 2 for Sega and Super NES.
Get the box!
I mean, what are friends for?
Kind of question that use of special there. Also, this is a completely inaccurate commercial because anyone who has played this game knows that if you do enough terrible stuff to Pac-Man, he will stop responding to what you say or do. That commercial is horrible and it doesn't feel right. And I don't know what the hell Namco was thinking with that. It's a horrible, mean-spirited commercial.
You can do it.
With marshmallows and corn puffs, Pac-Man cereal's part of a good breakfast.
You can do it! You can do the Pac-Man!
You can do it. You can do the Pac-Man. Do the Pac-Man. I think only Miss Pac-Man is allowed to do that. I'm sure you'll look really cool when you go to the dance floor and start doing the frickin' Pac-Man. That's a true reason why Miss Pac-Man isn't in the Pac-Man games anymore. She left when someone else did the Pac-Man.
Morning, kids. It's a Pac-Man day with my crispy corn cereal coming your way.
With marshmallows.
Delicious.
I'm Inky.
I'm Blinky.
I'm Pinky.
I'm Clyde.
With the marshmallows you'll find inside of Pac-Man.
There goes a Pac-Pac. And Inky too.
I'm saying again, Inky did nothing wrong. Inky was trying to get the kids some cereal. Hashtag Inky did nothing wrong. Inky did nothing wrong. Also, I love how neon this freaking bedroom is. I wish my bedroom looked like that when I was a kid. How many cereals did this round dweeb get? He got a lot. Well, he got one cereal, but he got a lot of commercials for it. I still stand by my statement. I think the ghosts in this commercial look adorable. I wish the ghosts looked like this in canon because they look so cute in these commercials.
He's marshmallow. You can chop him too.
It's
part of this nutritious breakfast.
It's with
marshmallows.
Delicious.
Wait a minute. What was with that end with Pac-Man just coming real close to us going, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. That feels weirdly creepy. Pac-Man just suddenly going up right up to your face going, yeah. Yeah. Buy the cereal, kids. Or I'll find you. Another Pillsbury Doughboy moment with Pinky. Poor Pinky getting the bad touch.
Stop it!
It's a form of abuse!
Why is Inky getting, like, chomped in these commercials? What did poor Inky do to deserve this? Inky did nothing wrong. Hashtag Inky did nothing wrong.
Who's eating his way through Arby's? Pac-Man! Arby's new Pac-Man glass is so popular, everything at Arby's is being gobbled up. There goes a roast beef deluxe. There goes a sub. Whoops, there goes our logo. Come to Arby's today for your fabulous Pac-Man glass. But you better hurry, that Pac-Man is insatiable. There's no stopping him. Get your official Pac-Man glass today, only at Arby's.
Only 59 cents. Nice. But that costs like $50 on eBay now. Yeah, I used to have that glass when I was a kid. I don't have it anymore. I think my parents sold it at a garage sale or something. Honestly, I wouldn't mind having one of those glasses again, because I'm going to need to get a lot of new glasses for the new place I'm moving into. So that would be a nice glass to have, actually. I'd actually use it, too. Hopefully it doesn't use lead paint like the freaking Garfield one supposedly did. Yeah, that was a pretty good ad. Pretty decent ad. 59 cents, though. Holy crud. That still seems crazy cheap. I mean, I know it was the 80s, but it still seems insane.
Now from Atari, a great new video game, Pac-Man. To stay alive, Pac-Man must eat power pills, vitamins, and ghosts.
I'll put you in stock mode now.
But beware, the ghosts bite back.
You've got 2 minutes.
Pac-Man's appetite is insatiable. To keep ahead of the game depends on your skill at feeding him.
Supper is served.
Pac-Man, the all-consuming video game, only from Atari.
Until all are consumed. Also, yeah, you can tell this is the 80s because, like, oh, those darn women keeping us men from playing our video games and having fun. She just gives up anyways and gives them the food, but hey, they got what they deserved. Pac-Man ate their food because they weren't doing what they were supposed to. They got what they deserved. Grant, Pac-Man didn't just eat the food. He seemingly ate the entire, like, area of that the world and left them in a void that they're stuck in for the rest of their life. Should have listened to Mom. Just saying. I like that Pac-Man was literally jumping on the heads of other Pac-Men, and they seemed to be perfectly okay with it. In fact, I think they were happy about it. These other Pac-Men are happy that Pac-Man is jumping on their heads. Pac-Men are into some weird stuff. Pac-Land, a Japanese ad for a game based on an American cartoon based on a Japanese game. Yeah, I agree, though. This ad is actually really cute. The animation's actually pretty nice, and yeah, it's really cute. This Pac-Man's superior to all those other Pac-Men because he has a hat. That's just how the Pac world works, man. I don't write the rules. Namco does. Talk to Namco. Pac-Man's never been the same since he stopped wearing a hat. He really hasn't, you know?
Go, Pac-Man!
Let's break for dinner. Come on in for some new Pac-Man macaroni and cheese dinner.
Wow. Uh-oh, there's the ghost.
We'll help you get energized with new Pac-Man macaroni and cheese. Delicious macaroni shaped like us, all covered with lots of great cheddar cheese sauce.
Mmm, great dinner.
Gulp.
We're energized!
How about ghosts for dessert?
New Pac-Man macaroni and cheese dinner. Cool. It'll help you get energized, too.
For a brief second there, I thought, like, Pac-Man ate his wife. Oh, wait, lewd. I also like how Pac-Man went and chased a ghost, and Miss Pac-Man's just like, I'm just gonna sit here and watch. It looks nothing like them. It really doesn't. Sue wasn't here, so she could keep her dignity. Yeah, that's right. It's a cute commercial. Yeah, it's a good mix of live-action and animation, actually. Did a pretty good job on that.
Mr. Arcade, I need help. My husband won't come home.
Pac-Man, I can help.
Get him, Pac-Man!
Stand back.
This is the official tabletop version of Midway's Pac-Man.
It looks the same!
And it plays the same. Monsters, power capsules...
It looks the same? Excuse me, what? That looked nothing like thing like the original. But it doesn't play like it either. Looks the same, my ass. Yeah, I bet you thought the Atari 2600 version looked the same too. Look at this guy's face. This guy looks like he's too into Pac-Man, and this is coming from someone who absolutely loves the Pac-Man games. If I ever look like that while playing Pac-Man, I think somebody needs to, like, do an intervention with me.
Sounds even displays best score. And best of all,
you can take Pac-Man home.
Official Midway Pac-Man for one or two players. The arcade game you can take home with you from Coleco.
I don't know if that's going to help your problem, lady. He's still going to be on the Pac-Man machine the whole time. I mean, he's still going to be ignoring you. Weirdly, because of the fact that the way they had the LCD set up, the ghost had a like little Pac-Man inside of the ghost whenever it moved around, and it looked really weird and kind of disturbing. That guy that was playing the Pac-Man machine looks like he's got some problems. I think giving him an arcade machine to take home is just adding to his problems more than solving them. I think he's got Pac-Man fever. He's not coming back. A lot of good ones in this section. Also a lot of absolute bullshit. But I do have to say I really love the Pac-Man cereal commercials. I like the last one in this because I just love the neon room look to the whole thing. It looks really good. Even if Pac-Man's a little creepy at the end with his yeah. I thought the Arby's one looked really cute, too. The Japanese Pac-Land one, absolutely adorable. That one is the best one of all of these, in my opinion, because that one is just absolutely adorable. But yeah, that's Pac-Man. I don't know if I'll find any more of those anytime soon. But if I do, I'll definitely let you guys know. So in the comments, give me some more suggestions of commercials you'd like to see me cover. Because I really enjoy these. They're really fun. Let me know in the comments and we'll see what happens. See ya!